In our previous discussion about rectifiers, we discussed full-wave rectifiers and how they are different from half-wave rectifiers. We also discussed one type of full-wave rectifier, the bridge full-wave rectifier, and learned how it operates to rectify both positive and negative half cycles of the AC input. In this tutorial, we will discuss the second type of full-wave rectifier, the center-tapped full-wave rectifier, and review how it operates. The reason why this type of full-wave rectifier is called a center-tapped rectifier is because it uses a center-tapped transformer. If you noticed in the schematic diagrams that we showed in the half-wave and bridge full-wave rectifier tutorials, you can see that the transformer has only a single winding on the secondary side. So if we want to create a power supply that uses a half-wave or bridge full-wave rectifier, we just use transformers that only have a single winding on the secondary side. Transformers may have different numbers of windings on their primary and secondary sides. Some transformers only have a single winding on their primary and secondary sides, but most of the transformers I've encountered have multiple windings on both sides. For example, the Triad Magnetics VPS24-5400 that we used in other tutorials, it uses dual windings on both sides and can be configured to have a series or parallel configuration. If you're interested to learn how to wire transformers, we've done a tutorial on that, so you can check it out on our website, CircuitBread.com. For a center-tap transformer, this type of transformer is designed to produce two secondary voltages with a common connection at the center of the secondary winding. So the two voltages are the same, and they can also provide the same power. From one end to the center tap, the voltage is half of the total secondary voltage, which you can see by inspection. In this image, you can see how a center-tapped transformer is connected to a center-tapped full-wave rectifier. One of the differences between center-tapped and bridge rectifier is the number of diodes used to rectify both positive and negative half cycles of the AC input. A bridge rectifier uses 4 diodes, while a center-tapped rectifier uses only 2 diodes. So let's discuss how a center-tapped full-wave rectifier operates. You can see the polarities on the secondary winding of a center-tapped transformer during the positive half cycle of the AC input. In this case, D1 is forward biased while D2 is reverse biased. So the current flows through D1 and enters the load, and then returns to the transformer through the center tap connection. When the AC input switches to the negative half cycle, the polarities on the secondary winding of the center tap transformer are reversed. So this time, D1 is reverse biased and D2 is forward biased. The current flows through D2 and enters into the load in the same direction as it entered during the positive half cycle of the AC input, and then returns through the transformer through the center tap connection. Since the current entered the load in the same direction in both positive and negative half cycles, the voltage across the load is a full wave rectified DC voltage. But it's still a pulsating DC, which needs to be filtered before using as a DC power supply. The same with the bridge full wave rectifier, the average value of a full wave rectified voltage can be determined by the equation V average equals 2 times the peak voltage divided by pi. The peak output voltage of a center tapped full wave rectifier is only equal to the half of the transformer secondary voltage minus the forward voltage of the diode. If you're going to check the current flow during the positive and negative half cycle of the AC input, you will notice the load only sees half of the transformer secondary voltage and not the total secondary voltage. So to determine the peak output voltage across the load, check what is half of the transformer secondary voltage and use the equation V peak out is equal to V peak secondary over 2 minus 0.7 volts. Now for the peak inverse voltage, PIV, of the diodes in a center tapped full wave rectifier, let's assume that the AC input is in the positive half cycle, so D1 conducts with a 0.7 volt diode drop, while D2 is reverse biased. By using Kirchhoff's voltage law, we get that the PIV is equal to the voltage peak on the secondary minus the 0.7 volt diode voltage drop. So the PIV that D2, or D1 during the negative half cycle, must withstand while in reverse bias condition is equal to the secondary voltage of the center tap transformer minus 1 diode drop. In this tutorial, we've discussed center tapped full wave rectifiers and their operation. We've also discussed briefly how a center-tap transformer is designed. I hope you found this tutorial interesting or helpful. If you have any questions or comments, leave it in the comments below or go to CircuitBread.com. If you haven't already, subscribe to our channel, like the video, and we'll catch you in the next one.